A key feature of the immune system is the ability to distinguish self from non-self or foreign. This remarkable ability is necessary because our bodies are constantly exposed to pathogens, for example, viruses. The basis of its ability to distinguish between both is the presentation of antigens to immune cells. Once an immune cell recognizes its specific antigen, the body launches an immune response to protect itself. Antigens are presented on the cell surface by two protein classes, MHC class 1 and MHC class 2. Let's get started with MHC class 1 molecules. Cytosolic proteins are transported to the proteasome. A proteasome is a complex that degrades proteins into small peptides of approximately 15 amino acids in length. These peptides are delivered into the endoplasmic reticulum by a TAP transporter. In the endoplasmic reticulum, TAP interacts with the MHC class 1 molecule, which is linked to several helper proteins. The term MHC stands for Major Histocompatibility Complex and refers to the molecule's importance in determining compatibility in organ transplantation. When the MHC class 1 molecule permanently binds to one of the peptide fragments, the TAP transporter and helper proteins dissociate. The antigen-loaded MHC class 1 molecule is pinched off into a vesicle and migrates through the Golgi apparatus to the cell surface. Fusion of the vesicle membrane with the plasma membrane results in the release of the antigen MHC class 1 complex. The complex can then be recognized by effector CD8 T cells. Now let's take a detailed look at the MHC class 2 antigen presentation pathway. Exogenous antigens are taken up by cells with endocytic activity. In the endosome, antigens interact with MHC class 2 molecules. The binding site of these MHC class 2 molecules is initially blocked by a small molecule. However, another helper protein present in the endosome is capable of facilitating the exchange of this small molecule with any available antigen. The vesicle then travels to the cell surface, fuses with the plasma membrane, and presents the antigen MHC class 2 complex on the cell surface. The antigen can now be recognized by CD4 T helper cells. So, what's the main purpose of these two antigen presentation pathways? Antigens presented by MHC class 1 are usually derived from inside the cell and are often referred to as endogenous antigens. These antigens can be derived from the cell, representing a normal self-antigen or neoantigens, which are derived from cancer cells. Other endogenous antigens include viral components from virus-infected cells. In contrast, MHC class 2 antigens are acquired from outside the cell and are therefore referred to as exogenous antigens, for example, extracellular bacteria,